Hey, what's up guys, it's Iman, and in this video I want to show you how to set up Microsoft Ads conversion tracking so that you can start seeing sales in your Microsoft Ads dashboard. Now you do need to have access to your landing page and potentially your thank you page. So if you're an affiliate and you don't have access to either, this will not be possible, okay? So in this video, I am assuming you have control over your landing page or thank you page, whatever it is you want to track. So for the purpose of this video, we'll be using this landing page here for Synergy Spanish. And then when people enter their email, they'll be taken to this thank you page, okay? So for the purpose of this video, we want to track how many people sign up, how many people enter their emails. And then what I'm going to show you here, you guys can apply to anything, whether it's sales, upsells, downsells, anything like that. So let's get straight into it. So there are two things we have to do here within Microsoft Ads. The first thing we need to do is set up the UET tag. That's their tag here. It's like a universal tag that will allow Microsoft Ads to communicate with your website. The second thing we have to do is set up the conversion goal. And this is where we will specify exactly what it is we want to track given the tag on our pages, all right? So let's get into it. So we're gonna click on UET tag, and then I have my interface here for the Unbounce landing pages. This is the landing page. This is the thank you page. By the way, I do use Unbounce here. It is my recommended landing page builder of my choice. I've been using it for about 5 years, but you guys can use whatever you want. Just follow the steps I'm gonna show you, okay? So we clicked on UET tag over here. And as you can see, I have a lot of tags active, but we're just gonna create another one as an example again. So click on create UET tag. We'll give it a name. Let's say another UET tag, YouTube. We can leave the description blank. We can click save and next. And then you have all these options. So if you have Google Tag Manager, you can set it up that way. You could set it up using a website editing platform like WordPress, Wix. So they have specific integrations already. Makes it super simple. You can send it to a developer or as we're going to do in this video, we're going to do it ourselves. So I'm going to click this option here, click on next. And then it's telling you what to do, right? So copy the tag and paste it between that head tags of every page of your site. So you're going to copy the tag. Okay, you're gonna go back to your website, in this case here, our landing page. We're gonna click edit. We're gonna go to the thank you page as well. While it's loading, click on edit. And we need to put the tag here on both of these, okay? So if you have the capability to put the code on every single page of your site right away, do that. With Unbounce, we don't, so I'm just gonna do it manually in putting it on every page. So I'm gonna click on add new JavaScript. So whatever landing page builder you're using, find the JavaScript section or the code section. And we're just going to paste the code here. We're going to put it in the head section, as they said. And then we're going to say Microsoft Ads UET tag, right? And then let's just go back real quick, make sure it looks right. Yeah, so here is just it's more spaced out. Over here, it's all kind of squeezed in, but that's okay. It's not going to matter. So we're going to click on done, click on save, click on republish, republish. And give it a second to load. We're going to click got it. Then come back here to the thank you page. We're going to add it here as well. We're going to say head section, and we're going to say Microsoft Ads UET tag. We're going to click done. We're going to hit save. We're going to hit republish. And that is good. Okay, so now these two can communicate. So we're going to click got it. Oops. And now these should have the tag on the pages. Now, if you guys want to confirm that you set it up correctly, you can get an extension called the UET Tag Helper extension. I believe it's something like that. Yeah, UET Tag Helper by Microsoft Advertising. So if you want to make sure that you set it up correctly before you go any further, you can do that. So we're just going to click to add to Chrome, click here, and then it should show up over here, right there. So we're just going to pin it to the taskbar. And now if we come back here to these pages, if we click here and click on and then refresh the page, it should show up a little green one right there. See, it says the UET tag is set up correctly. You can even check the ID 4336. Come back here. The ID is, well, let's click on next and then click on done. And we should see the ID here. Let's see, where is it? It's this one. Another UET tag YouTube is the one, 4336 right there, right? And as you can see, that's the same one, 4336. Now we can come back here also. We can activate this one and click on refresh. So this is how you confirm that you set up the UET tag correctly. Now, once you do this, once you verify that it's set up correctly, you can go in and actually set up your conversion. So what is it that you want to track? So you're going to click on tools, click on conversion goals, and you're just going to go ahead and click on create. And then this is a website. So we're going to click website. what category, right? So if you're tracking sales, you would select purchase or add to cart or whatever it is you're tracking. So in our case, it's going to be a sign up. So we can click sign up over here. And then it's going to be destination URL, right? So when somebody lands on our thank you page, we know that they signed up because the only way they get to the thank you page is by signing up, right? So then we're going to select destination URL. We're going to click next, and then we're going to give it a name. So we're going to say Spanish signups, or let's be more specific. Let's say Synergy Spanish signups. That's the name of the product. Then we have a destination URL. So you could say contains, right? So as long as the URL contains this, for example, this whole string, it will be counted as a conversion, right? So I'm going to delete the HTTP because it might be HTTP, might be HTTPS, and we're just going to use this, right? Unbouncepages.com/these. So as long as all these characters are included in the person's URL bar, once they land on the page and the UET tag is on that page, this conversion will fire, okay? Now, revenue value, there's no value here for a lead, but if you do the math, if you work backwards, you would be able to, you know, add the value right there if you want. So I'm just going to leave it at that. Now, these are other additional options. You can leave them as default, but I will quickly go over them. The scope just tells you what account you want this to be on. The count says how you want to count the conversions. So if one person clicks and lands on the page three times, do you want that to be counted as three conversions or as one because it's only one person? You have the conversion window where if somebody clicks on your ad, right, and then they buy, let's say 60 days later, do you want that to still be considered a conversion or will it pass the deadline? So this shows basically how relevant and fresh your conversions actually are. So if you set this to 30 days and somebody clicks on your ad and then they buy 29 days later, that will be considered a conversion. That's how that works. A view through conversion window is basically how long do you want to give somebody after they see your ad, not necessarily just click on it. Next, you have the include in conversion. So what this is you have two different types of columns in Microsoft and Google Ads. You have the all conversions column and you have the just the conversions column. So the conversions column are basically the most important conversions you have. So if you set up a lot of conversion tracking objectives, let's say you set lead capture, you set some upsell, downsell, phone calls, the main conversion for you is probably the sales, right? So you would want to include your main conversions in your main conversions column because these are the conversions that really matter. So that's what this is. And last but not least, you have the conversion attribution model. Unlike Google Ads, where you used to have a bunch of choices, here you just have two, last click and last touch. You're going to leave it at last click. There's not much of a difference between them. And then you're going to click on next. You can turn on enhanced conversions if you like, which basically will allow Microsoft to match personal data that you have from people signing up with existing information that Microsoft has. So that might make your conversions more accurate because now the data will match. It will ensure that somebody converted, things like that. Or you can just say, I don't want to use it. Either one's fine. Click on save and next. And then we already installed the UET tag, so we can just select this option here for the conversion, make sure. And by the way, you want to make sure the ID number here, 25054358, which does not match the one that I told you right here, it's 4336. Therefore, you want to change your tag. So click on use a different tag and then select another UET tag, click save. And now this one is 4336. 4336. So that matches, right? So that's what you want to do. Click on save and next. And then it can take up to 24 hours for it to verify, but that should be it. Congratulations. You've set up your tag. You've set up your conversion. So here it is. It's unverified, but that's okay. Once you actually start setting the traffic, this should work and this should show up and become verified. So you can click on view dashboard over here just to see the process, see the stats, see the results. And then once you're done with that, if you go back to all your campaigns, let me just show you where you can actually see the conversions. So then you would go over here and your conversions tab will be here. So you'll see all your conversions over here, at least the ones that you selected showing the conversions column, right? Now, if you click on columns, click on modify columns, click on conversions, you will see you have conversions over here and then you have all conversions, right? So all conversions is every single conversion that you set up for this UET tag. And then conversions are the special ones, right? The most important conversions that actually matter, like the sales. That's the most important thing, the most important conversion. And then you can adjust your columns over here, but this is the main one you want, right? Conversions and or all conversions here. So as long as you have those added, you can just click add, click on apply, and that's going to show up over here, your conversion step. And that is it. Hope this video was helpful for you. If you guys found this valuable, I do invite you to check out my website at ivanmehta.com, where I offer you guys a free 55-page affiliate marketing guide to help you get started with affiliate marketing, as well as training courses on these paid ad networks like Google Ads and, in this case, Microsoft Ads. So if you want to learn Microsoft Ads very thoroughly, see some case studies, see some numbers, I do invite you to check out this course. Other than that, thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.